In the world of stablecoins, we have some really, really surprising developments going on. And as always, I am not going to leave you just out in the rain, but I will, I'll just let you know about the latest developments and back it all up with really, really trusted sources, right? So let's dive right into it. I'll show you what's going on in stablecoin world and dive into to everything. So let's check it out. Here is a site called Artemis.xyz. So Artemis is one of the most trusted blockchain analytics sites, and this is one of their dashboards here, and we see all the stablecoin stats here. Transfer volume in the last 3 months was $1.18 trillion. So that's a lot of volume, right? So now let's see how that volume goes on the various chains here, right? And you know me, my channel is mostly about Solana. So I'm a big Solana fan, and I'm building Zandium.com, the scalable storage layer for Solana. So if you haven't heard of Zandium, go to Zandium.com, check it out. But let's go back to stablecoins here. And we see the transfer volume here, and the green stuff is Solana, right? So as you saw here in October 2023, Solana had a tiny market share of stablecoin transfers. But look at what happened in November. Look at what happened in December, right? So, and in January. So if we look at the January numbers, which are basically the December numbers, right? It's from January 1st, and it's for the past 30 days. So these are the December numbers, and we see Ethereum still the leader at $335.72 billion trading volume, but we see Solana with 322. Holy cannoli, that is not a big difference. And if you see the trend here, the trend definitely speaks for Solana. The gray area here is Ethereum, so not much going on in the gray area. It was 332, 370, 374, and it went down to 335 here, right? So definitely Solana took some market share from Ethereum, and they also took a lot of market share from Tron, which was one of the big players in the stablecoin field. But at least in December, it was losing some ground. So we don't know how it all develops, but what we do know is that the Solana chain is a great chain for stablecoin transfers. Fees are ridiculously low. Speed and transfer speed is ridiculously fast. The chain is super stable recently. There hasn't been an outage in a long, long time. So, and there are many, many popular stablecoins out there. So USDC is one of the most popular stablecoins on the Solana chain. And recently, Paxos has released its USDP on the Solana chain, and that helped drive up the volume also. And Solana volume in general, not only stablecoins, but in general, has picked up like crazy in December, as you all know. So yeah, the stablecoin world is, it's Solana Pay is a more and more successful. Visa is working with Solana stablecoins, and Shopify is working with Solana stablecoins. I recently just made a purchase with Solana Pay on a Shopify page. So yeah, I mean, Solana seems conquering the real world, and stablecoins are a big, big thing for that. So if you like content like this, I have a quick ask for you. Please give me that like button. It really means a lot to me. Also subscribe to my channel, And leave me a comment what you think about the future of Solana versus other chains in the stablecoin field, right? So, and talking about Zandium and what we're building on the Solana chain, and talking about Solana. So, if you have any Sol, you will be leaving money on the table if you don't stake it, right? So, you need to stake your Sol. You almost get like 8% or something like that. The APY is fluctuating a little bit. But if you go to Zandium.com, as we see it here, so first of all, sign up for our Discord, and you can also subscribe to our email list. You can subscribe to us on X. But here is the most important button, right? It says stake here. So if you have some Sol, click on stake here. You come to that page here, and you can just connect your wallet up here and stake your Solana. And the estimated APY, can you believe it, right now, currently, as of the current state of our validator, is 8.23%. So why would you leave that on the table? Why would you give a cut to anyone, right? We don't charge a commission. We're at 0% commission, and we're going to leave it at 0% commission for the foreseeable future. And also, why would you go to liquid staking and all these things where you give a cut of everything to some liquid staking pool, to whatever out there? It's just the highest returns you get when you stake to a validator yourself, stake to a validator that you trust. My channel has been out there for over a year. It's very, very successful. I'm fully doxxed, and I've been running that Solana validator for over a year. So yeah, I think if you trust us, just trust yourself with our Zandium validator. We would really, really appreciate it. And yeah, that was my short video today. If you have any more comments on the stablecoin scene, please leave me that comment. And thanks so much for watching, and catch you guys later. Bye.